a can from Autism Uncovered, and I'm going to talk to you about using visual timetables. So a visual timetable is a breakdown of your day. It doesn't have to be the whole day, it could be half of the day. In fact, for young children, I'd actually recommend you just do half a day at a time. That's more than enough. And also, you might not know exactly what's going on that day and what you're going to do. So it allows you some flexibility to change. Now, if you've seen the first one, the introduction, that will really help. It'll help make sense what I'm going to say. But if you've got a bank of pictures, words, photographs, drawings of things that you regularly do, you will have all the things that you hopefully need in for your visual timetable. What is important is that you put on the things like, we're going to eat dinner, we're going to have our tea, we're going to bed, all the things that you think, well, that's pretty obvious, but actually for some children that makes a really big difference, so that they can see it's that reassurance, yep, all these things are going to be happening, as well as we're going to the shop, we're going to visit someone, we've got somebody coming round. So to make a visual timetable, you need something like this, which is obviously just, you know, a bit of cardboard and some packaging. And you would start by having either stick back Velcro down here, or you could have blue tack. The only thing is, if you do have blue tack, some children actually eat the blue tack, and obviously, you don't want that. It could turn out it's a great fidget toy, but if they're going to eat it, I'd just place the pictures on and you can just lay it flat. So a visual timetable for the morning, say. You'd have, possibly if you want, to put the day up here. You can do if you're teaching them about the days, but maybe they're not ready for that. Maybe it's not important. But you would have what's going on first up here. So it might be, have your breakfast. And then when you've had your breakfast, down at the bottom here, you'd have something. It could be a small box from a bit of packaging. It could be an envelope that says finished. If you read this in conjunction with the handout, it'll help make sense. But you need something to put your pictures in. So it might be you get up, you have your breakfast, then you take that picture off. Get them to take the picture off if they will. If not, let them see you take it off and put it in the bottom. And you say, okay, we've done that, next we're going to get washed, and then we're going to brush our teeth. So you have a wash, and then you take that picture off with them, show them it going in the finish box, you look at the next thing, brushing teeth, take that off. And then the next thing, now that could be the park, it could be watching television, it could be visiting an aunt, an uncle, a friend, a grandparent, or somebody coming round. And then it could be dinner time. So then in the afternoon, you do another schedule for the afternoon. You don't have to do each minute of the day, obviously. Nobody knows. But the main thing of what's happening, so that when your child's saying, what's next, what's next, what's next, you can show them the timetable. And you're not just saying the one word and then it's disappeared. You're actually showing them this as well. This makes a massive difference. I was skeptical at first. I thought, is that really going to make much difference? Have I got time to be printing all the pictures out? Having worked in schools in different settings, so in a mainstream school with children from 4 up to 11, in a special needs secondary school with students with severe learning difficulties from 11 to 23, I can assure you it does make a big, big difference, because you're backing up what you've said. So have a look at the handout as well. And if you've got any questions and you want any more clarity, please just message me and I'm happy to help you. Thank you. That was Visual Timetables. I'm Lorna McCann from Autism Uncovered. Thanks.